So, this is Otto. Tell everyone, what's your Insta?
Hi everyone, Otto Barclay.
And?
Hi everyone, I'm Sunday85.
Shout out to those two, always good bumping into fellow London photographers. Go check them out. Both of them are really, really good.
What it would do. I was such an awful man. I wondered what would happen if I tested it.
Yes, what's going on, people? Welcome back, hope you're doing well, and welcome to yet another behind-the-scenes POV type street photography video here in London, where I show you some of my good pictures, bad pictures, and locations so that you can go out and do this for yourself, maybe. I don't know, waffling. So, in today's video, I started in the Barbican. Now, I'm going to do a whole separate video now, I think, because there's definitely a lot there to be had. Barbican is, I guess it was like an old council estate. It was then renovated, gentrified, you know what I mean, made modern and all hipster and really expensive. And now it's quite a good place to do street photography. You have loads of like cool architecture, cool textures, and you can create these little pockets where you can frame subjects, which I think is very good. So I started there. I then walked towards St. Paul's. To be honest, St. Paul's is a bit dead. Like I legit didn't enjoy it this time. I think, okay, it's because St. Paul's works the best, at least for me, in sort of late autumn to around early spring. The colder months, for sure. I just think the light there is a lot better, a lot more pleasant. Maybe because it's a bit lower, you get deeper, longer shadows. I don't know. But given the fact that autumn is here, we'll soon find out. So I got two images there. Both of them were dead. I think both of them are actually my least favourite from the day. So after St. Paul's, where did I go? I went towards Embankment. There were some really wicked clouds. Look, these really sort of high dark clouds, but these really low sort of lighter clouds, and then vice versa as well. And because it was really windy, they were moving quick, so I did that time lapse, which I really liked. And then I took the photo of the London Eye with obviously the white clouds behind it. I did want to go on the London Eye, but by the time I would have got to the top, all of the interesting clouds, shall we say, would have just blown away. It would have just been bland, so I didn't bother. Instead, I walked down South Bank, towards Bankside, and eventually towards more London and Tower Bridge, which is where I ended the day because the light went a bit dead. I was hungry and needed a beer. So that's the route. Let's talk about photos. Oh, no. Before photos, let's talk about gear. Same as last one. It was the X-T4 16-55. Aperture priority ranging between f2.8 and maybe f6 for 80% of the photos. Shutter speed ISO was an auto. But obviously, for the images that I talk about, you will see all the information, and that's it. Now, let's get into the images. The first one that I really liked is of the man standing. It was South Bank, and he was just next to the water. The tide was coming out. And what happens in that particular area, when the tide comes out, you have like these really nice sort of S's running where the water kind of meets the sand or the stones or the mud or the dirt, whatever it is. And the way you were standing, like, there were two things going on. The first, well, more than two things. The first one is the water line, so the S line, kind of acts like as a leading line going towards him. So that's good. Also, he's framed by the bridge. That's good. Also, there's a clear sense of scale because you can clearly see the man, you can clearly see the space around him, as well as the surrounding architecture, which builds that sense of scale up. There is a bit of contrast going on between him and the water behind, so he stands out even more. And overall, I like the edit and the direction that took this edit in. Because it was a moody day anyway, so I've just kind of played on that, exaggerated the moodiness of that afternoon. And as with all my images, I reduced the clarity just to give it a more soft effect, soft feel, I guess. So yeah, that's why I like the image. Now, the one thing I don't like about it are the two red lampposts. Now, I know that's part of the scene. I can't exactly go there, angle grind them off, go back and take the photo. Certainly not unless I want to get arrested. So if I were to print this, if I were to put this on a display somewhere, or if I really wanted to make it 100%, I would definitely remove them in Photoshop. However, for this purpose, I've just left them in because I wasn't going to do any of those things. So they take away from the image, in my opinion, but it's part of the location, so what can you do? So the second favourite photo from the day was of the guy in the hat where I took the picture from a low angle. I saw him coming up and I wanted to get his photo because I think overall his appearance was good. But the problem is the sort of background where I was standing was really messy. There was loads of people. So if I got that picture, it just would have looked boring, to say the least. And the only option I had was just to go low and then take the photo up to then have the sky as the background. It's a decision that I'm ultimately happy with. And honestly, it's one of the reasons I like this photo is because it's as a result of a predetermined decision I made with regards to the composition rather than intuitively taking pictures. So normally when I take photos, I don't actively think of composition. I mean, certainly 75% of the time, I simply just point at a camera at something that I think looks good for whatever reason, take a picture of, and then I analyze it afterwards. This was one of the few cases where I actually analyzed the scene beforehand and then take the picture, which I still think is a good way of working and certainly a way of working that I'm working towards improving on. So that's one of the reasons I like it. The second reason, I like the light fall off on the skin. His skin complements the color of the hat. If I could improve it in some way, obviously the backpack is a bit of a distraction, but again, it's not something that you can really do. And I just like the simplicity of it. Overall, everything comes together nicely. It's simple, it's straight to the point, it's a clear subject. The lighting, I think, is good. And as with the rest of the images from the day, the overall editing is very much subdued, very more moody, which I just think works well in this particular case. So those were the two images that I liked. Now let me quickly talk about some images which I thought were a bit rubbish. And to be honest with you, I think overall, the level of images were fairly close to each other. Normally I have one or two really good ones, one or two really rubbish ones, and then everything else is like in the middle. This was definitely a bit more close. But the two rubbish ones were actually the ones from St. Paul's. The first one was the guy sitting on the staircase. The reason that image is rubbish is there are many reasons. The colour grading is not good, I don't think. Secondly, it was a very lazy image. There's absolutely zero thought that's gone into it. I saw him sitting there and literally I just walked around, took like 10 different versions of that image from different angles, picked the best one in post. And it was just a very lazy image. I didn't work for it. I didn't feel like I've worked for that. And I didn't feel like it really communicates anything. I think you can understand the sense of scale a little bit if you know St. Paul's, but if you don't, then that could just be anywhere as well. So for those reasons, I don't like it. There's not much else going for it. And second photo that I don't like is also from St. Paul's, and it's of the lady sitting in front of this wall. Similar reasons, actually, to the first one. It didn't take any effort to take it. I literally just walked around, found the best composition that I thought at the time and took the photo. I mean, the composition's okay, but overall, the image is bland. There's nothing there that draws you in. There's nothing there that makes you wonder, oh, cool, you know, I wonder what it's like to be there or anything like that. I mean, if you compare it to the first photo that I liked of the guy standing by the water, certainly for me, when I look at that image, I wonder what it looks like where he's standing. I wonder if it's cold, if it's windy, if it's wet, etc. Whereas with this image, it's just boring. There's nothing there. I mean, what do you wonder what it's like to sit down by a public toilet? So, yeah, that's why I don't like it. And as I've said, I think in last week's video, just because these images are rubbish, throw away, it doesn't mean that I will not take them again. I will always actively take photos and then get rid of them later because I enjoy the process of taking photos. And also, every time you take such a rubbish photo, you learn, as I'm doing now with you, about why it was rubbish. So you certainly think a bit different in many cases going forwards. Right, that's all. I have spoken enough. I hope you found something useful in this video to take away. If you have, leave your comments down below. And as always, let me know which images you like and which images you don't like. And that's it. So thank you again. Like, subscribe, share, all the good stuff. And I shall see you in the next video. Have a fantastic day and see you soon. In a bit.